Sai Ram to everybody. With pranams to Swami, with feelings of thanks and gratitude to all of you for having been here this morning. This morning has a special feature. Before I go into the topic of the day, I would like to share with you a special feature of this morning. Once somebody asked Swami, I think it was Colonel Joga Rao, Bhagavan, you are giving free medical care, everything free of charge in the hospitals, and the medical care, surgical in particular, they're highly expensive, very highly expensive. Why can't we charge those people who can afford, who can pay the money? Or why can't we give concession who cannot pay, while we'll do it freely to everybody? See what our good Lord said. Heart attack is same to all three categories of people. There is nothing like rich heart attack, poor heart attack, and the average heart attack. Heart attack is heart attack. It has no distinction on grounds of bank accounts or financial status. So it must be offered free. Then this man has put another question. At this rate, spending lakhs of money on patients for surgery, how long can we maintain? Is it possible to run the hospital totally free of charge? Please note this point what Baba said. Because there is a guideline to every one of us in our individual lives. There are two ways of looking at things. One, this is what Baba did, this is what Baba said. One way. The second way of looking at things is, Baba said this so that I would act according to that. Baba did this so that I would follow his illustrious example. There are two ways of looking at it. I give prime importance to the second way, that we have to learn from his message and practice the way how he lived among us. Follow his example. That's how I take it. This is what Baba said. When your intentions are good, I repeat, when your intentions are good, help will come from all sources. You don't need to ask anybody. You don't need to beg anybody. You don't need to stretch your hand before anybody. The help will come on its own. Your intents are good, selfless, based on love. Help will be extended to you. Manasuloni bhavambu
manchidaina kaligi teerunu falasiddhi karyamandu.
If the intents are good in the mind, all your deeds, all your projects are bound to be successful.
Manasuloni bhavambu malinamaina falamu kuda ariti malinamaguru sachamaina matai sai mata.
If the intentions are evil, if the intentions are selfish, the results also will be a failure. Therefore, success or failure depends on our intentions. And Baba went on to say, when Rama started a project, Lord Ramachandra started a project of constructing a bridge across the ocean. Monkeys helped, squirrels helped, and also in the life of Sri Ramachandra, birds helped, Jatayu, demons helped, Vibhishana, squirrel helped. When monkeys, squirrels, demons, birds could help Rama, why not I receive from everybody the entire creation? That's what Baba said. Why not I receive from human beings? Why not? Don't doubt it. What I plan will happen, said Baba. Right from my childhood, a personal note, beg your pardon, I have got this desire to share whatever little I know. And this has grown to very high magnitudes, altitudes and platitudes in the highest measure after coming to Swami. Whatever little I know about Swami must be broadcast and telecast. I can't keep anything within me. You call me extrovert, whatever it is. Something like a cup which is full of coffee. Any more of coffee in the cup will spill out because cup is full. Similarly, when I read a discourse of Swami, it spills out, which I share in these talks with friends and fellow devotees. And in the course of time, I met a friend from Delhi by name Mr. Sood, who said, Anil Kumar, all these books must, all your talks must be documented. They should be published in the form of books. That's what Mr. Sood said. I simply laughed at him because it's an impossible task. Because I speak and go, where is the time to write? No time to write. Where is the time to edit, correct, and make a final script? No time. But that man went on, pestering me that I should publish a book. And he was back to Delhi. At that time, two professors from Andhra University, English, Department of English, Ramesh Datta of Department of English, and his wife, Professor Padma, Department of English, from Andhra University, they came to me on their own, they're pretty seniors. Had I been a student of English, I would have been their student. Different generation altogether. They came to me, both of them, they said, we'll translate your Satyopanishad in Telugu into English. We'll translate into English. I said, sir, would you do that? Yes. They did it. That's how Satyopanishad came in two volumes. Quite unexpectedly, by two eminent professors, internationally known. Later, same Ramesh Datta said, there is another book, you must have read it, Race of Radiance. Dialogue conversation between me and Swami in Kulwanta Hall. He used to talk to me for 2 years, every day, freely, putting questions and Swami giving replies. Radiance of Race. And same Ramesh Datta said, I'll translate Radiance of Race into English. And he did it. And then the early period of experiences with Swami, Divine Directions, is also done by the couple, Ramesh Datta and Mrs. Padma. Both of them are professors. Then both of them are quite aged, you know. They are my seniors. Finding out that they have no time and the body would not cooperate, I just kept quiet. Near Ganesha at the gate, Ganesh gate, you know that. There sat a man. He came to me straight. Mr. Anil Kumar, I have come to know that you need some editors to edit your talks and publish. I am Oja from Mumbai. He stays close to Juhu Beach. I never knew him. In Andhra, the names are Sharma, Murthy, Rao, that's all. He, Oja, he said. I said, sir, would you? Yes. And he did it. And it was he who published Sai Sandesh in English and also Psychology. These two are done by Oja. And then, as ill luck would have it, because Oja had number of health issues, well, he left us. Then I was just like that. Suddenly I got a letter from Trivandrum, Professor Vaidyanathan, a retired professor from Trivandrum University, English professor. He said, Anil Kumar, I would like to volunteer my services and help you in the publication of books. Quite welcome. Because I never met these people, they are coming on their own. Yes, sir. And that Vaidyanathan could carry on for, say, about 15 to 20 books released thereafter. Vaidyanathan, 20 books he edited, transcriptions, corrections, editing, everything is done by Professor Vaidyanathan. At the age of 78 only, with his wife bedridden, totally, completely helpless, lying like vegetable. I told him, sir, why do you worry like that? He said, if I do this, I'll be more healthy, I'll be more happy. Let me have this opportunity. Like that, in the literary field, publication of books, as on today, 27 books have been published by our such a size central trust, purely 100% because of the divine will and divine design. I am zero, I know that. I constantly remind myself that I am a zero, I am a zero, I am a zero. So that in the worst of the dreams, should I ever estimate something more, that I am not. So things are going on like that. And then it is at that time I had been to New Zealand. There in New Zealand I stayed with Revati Sundar. Revati and her husband Sundar. They are from Wellington, New Zealand. They settled there. And many young people there, we were talking. Suddenly some two or three youngsters, software engineers, they came and said, Uncle, do you know that you answered around 2,000 questions? I said, I don't count the number of questions. I am not a cricketer to count the number of runs or anything like that. You ask, I simply answer, that's all. They said, spread over 10 years, you answered 2,000 questions. Would you like to see them? What? Because they are all modern fellows, a child also expert in computer. Whereas a fellow like me is quite novel. I press it the wrong place, whole thing will go wash off. Well, those software fellows could show me all the questions in a very, very big computer. I mean, TV screen. Tuck, 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 all the 2,000 questions. I was wondering, is it true? Because I am quite new to that technology. This Revati is from Madras University, a good writer, good speaker, and a great devotee. Why I say that is, we are seeing the collection of Vibhuti there today. There at our house, Vibhuti comes from every picture, in every room of our family, in Wellington, New Zealand. Every room, every picture, every day. I stayed with them about 3 days. I saw with my own eyes. I am a direct witness. Great devotee, great singer. Sundaram standard bhajans. Then I requested Revati, with the help of these youngsters, why can't you edit all the questions topic wise? Let us publish them for the benefit of the devotees. She simply jumped at the opportunity and published 3 books. One is Quest Eternal. The second is Here and Now. And third one, Seeking Within. These 3 books contain question and answers only. Questions put to me across the globe, all over the world, and the responses. She classified and published those books. Well, things are happening like that. Happening. I don't say things are done. Things happened. It is at that time, 2 elderly persons that attend our satsangs, be that Sunday or Friday, they came to me and said, we'd like to translate a book into Hindi. Because most of the Indians speak Hindi all over North India. In South India, at least 50% know. They read Hindi, they can speak eloquently in Hindi. And it is a tragedy that I do not know Hindi. Hindi is a national language. I am ashamed of it. I do not know. They said, we will get it, we will translate. And they liberally came forward to extend every possible help to get it published by the trust. Is it true? Then I said, what book you want to translate? Because there are already 27. And they were holding in their hand the 3rd book, Seeking Within. Seeking Within is the book they selected to translate into Hindi. And they gave the Hindi title, Antah Anveshan. Antah meaning inner. Anveshana, inquiry. Seeking Within meaning self-inquiry. Look within. That is the title they gave it. A most apt title. There are the couple made for each other, totally dedicated to Swami. I have not seen them talking to anybody. I have not seen them socializing here. I never imagined that they are of very high stature in society. And they settled here in Puttaparthi by the command of Bhagwan Baba. And they published some books already in Hindi. They have got some experience. And they did this book, Seeking Within, a 3rd volume of question answer series. And those that know Hindi, 1 or 2 said, excellently done. Wonderful language. Good style, that they said. Who are they? One, Dr. Neeru Malhotra. And she is a retired doctor, retired from medical services, from Indian Navy, in the rank of a surgeon. And she is an accomplished lady as a doctor. And then, I understand they have come to the lotus feet of Bhagwan in the year 70s and 80. And in 89, Swami wanted them to settle here. And they are here among us. How they have come? Not after retirement. How have they come? Not in a position helpless. They sought premature retirement, voluntary retirement, because Swami wanted them to be here, and they are in our midst today. And Neeru Malhotra's husband, again a doctor, Vinod Malhotra, a retired man from medical services, Indian Navy. Both of them are doctors from medical services, having done an excellent job, very pious. At every stage we need some examples to emulate. Perhaps Swami wants me to emulate their example, how to be a vanaprastha, a recluse. there are some stages. Brahmachari, Grihastha. Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasi. These are the four stages. Brahmachari is the stage of celibate. Grihastha, householder. Vanaprastha, recluse. Sannyasa, a renunciant. So how to be Vanaprastha? After discharging our duties, we have to get into spiritual fold totally. Or else life becomes meaningless. I take this opportunity to welcome both of them to the dais, Dr. Neeru Malhotra and Dr. Vinod Malhotra, to go over here and then submit their composition, their compilation, their rendition into Hindi version to the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Closer, Amma.
It was Swami who just put a little thought in my mind to do some work which, to be very honest, when I read back, I think, did I really write these words? Or is it Swami who used my hand and wrote? Believe me, I have no Hindi background as such. I have been a medical student, science student. Most of my life for the last 52 years has been in South India. I've had any interactions, so to say, about Hindi. I'm saying this just to say that it is Swami who probably took my hand in his hand and made me write. And I'm extremely thankful to our Honorable Professor Anil Kumar, who gave me this opportunity, of course, above all is Swami, but at human level. And it's not with a sense of pride or sense of, but with a sense of bit of achievement. There are 5 more books also which have been done. Out of the 4 are already gone for printing or approval, and the 6th one I'm writing. In between, I had a little problem. So I have to kind of stop it. Problem of vision, so I couldn't write it. And I'm hoping and I'm requesting, sir, you'll give me opportunity of doing some more. It'll be a great, great divine opportunity if before leaving this body we could do something more. And I'm really grateful, of course, to our beloved Lord. But besides that, to you, sir, for giving me this opportunity.
God bless you, God bless you. God bless you with long life, healthy life, spiritual life. Thank you. That's what it is. That's what Swami is. That's what His will is. That's what His design is. May Bhagavan be with you forever and evermore. Bless you both and your family. Thank you very much. May success haunt you. May victory chase you in the years to come in different projects that you undertake from time to time. God bless you.